Hi, I'm Bill Cannedy from Golf Vacations Magazine, Concierge Travel Department, and today we're with Jim Carra, Director of Golf at Oakmont Golf Club in beautiful Santa Rosa. It's a gorgeous golf course, and Jim's going to give you a little tour of the golf course today.
Hi, I'm Jim Carra, Director of Golf at Oakmont Golf Club. We have 36 holes here. We have an east course and a west course. We call the east course the Beast of the East. It's a par 63. If you get a chance to come out, don't let that scare you. It's everything you want. We're going to be playing on the west golf course today. Both golf courses were completed in 1964. Ted Robinson designs, and it's a fun golf course, very walkable, very playable golf course. This is the second hole in the west. This is by far the most difficult hole in the golf course. There's a little pond right here with a creek that runs all the way down the right side. It's a little dogleg left to right. Trees down the right side. It opens up left, but if you go too far left, you're blocked to your approach to the green by a big tree that overhangs the front of the green. So ideally, you want to hit it right down the tree line and then far enough to get past the last tree with maybe a little fade so you have a shot into an open green. Let's go from here and see what happens. See, that's too far left, but I'll have a shot. Okay, as my drive came a little bit to the left side of the fairway, if you look at the green, you see a big oak tree that's blocking my path. So fortunately, I'm back far enough. I'm about 150 yards out. I should be able to hit it over the tree and land it on the green. We're here on the 10th tee now. This is the start of the back side. As you look down, this is a par 5 here at Oakmont, and it's a very narrow driving hole. There is a lake at the end. You can see the trees out there and then some tall shrubbery. There's a lake right there with a creek that goes across to the right side. As you play this hole, the big hitters have a tendency to drive it into the lake, so more than likely we're going to take a 3-wood off this box, try to hit it about 235, 240 to be short of the water, and then our second shot will have a chance to go for the green if we hit it up there close. If not, we have to worry about a creek and another dry bed creek about 100 yards short of the green. So here we are, number 10, ready to play. That one's a keeper. Okay, here we are in the middle of the fairway. I hit a pretty good drive. I've given myself a couple options. I might be able to get it. We're about 230 out, 225 out, and I possibly could get a drive there or 3-wood there. So my other option is, you can see the lake here. I've got a creek cutting across about 50 yards in front of me. I have another dry bed across about 90 yards short of the green that I need to either be in between or get over. So I'm going to try to hit it over and hit it on the green and try to start the backside with an eagle. Here we go. That's got a chance. There it is. Eagle 3. This is the 17th hole on the west golf course. Water all the way down to the right side, little dogleg left. The water curves all the way around to the back side of the green. There is a lake on the left side. There is OB left of the trees on the left. So you can see the hazard runs the entire right side of the hole. And then there is OB left, tree line left. And there's a lake about 250 out. Okay, pretty good drive again, so I'm fortunate for that. You can see I've got a lake, a little waterfall right in front of me. The creek is down the right. I've got three bunkers that I have to navigate around. So I've got one on the right side, green side bunker. This bunker past the lake is a little bit short. There's about 10 or 15 yards before the green. And then there's a bunker on the left side of the green there. I'm about 160 yards out. I'm gonna hit a 7-iron to a back pin, and let's hope I can get another one close. Here we go. Oh, that's right at it. That's right at it. Almost missed it left, but it went in. 18th hole here at Oakmont West. Beautiful backdrop, as you can see. We got a mountain in the background. This is one of the longer, tougher par fours. There's a lake right here that we're going to hit across, and then tree line down the right side, OB with trees on the left. So it does take a good drive here, and then the second shot is uphill all the way to the pin. So this is our final hole. Here we go. Bill, after a nice round, let's go in and have a nice drink and a good lunch here at the Quail Inn.